students. I am Aklim, faculty of science. Are you interested to learn science subject? Yes. I ask simple question about science. If you know answer, tell me. Okay, what do you mean by surrounding? Yes. Things which around us we call as surrounding. Yes. Give examples for objects which you see in your daily life in surrounding. Yes. Bird, vehicle, cow, then mountain, plants, chair, etc. Okay, these are the things which you see in your surrounding. Okay. Here, students, in your previous year classes, you learned about natural objects as well as artificial objects. Here, can you classify the objects are natural or artificial? Okay, let us see. Natural objects. Natural objects and artificial objects. Okay, what do you mean by natural objects? Yes, the objects which exist on their own are the objects which are made by God. We call it as natural objects. In the same way, artificial objects means the objects which are made by man. We call it as artificial objects. Okay, can you classify either the objects are natural or artificial? Okay, tell me, bus. Bus is natural or artificial? Artificial. Why bus is artificial? Because bus are made by man. Okay, so we call as bus is example for artificial objects. Next is bird. Bird is natural or artificial? Bird are example for natural objects. Why? Because birds are made by God. Okay, so we call as natural objects. Vehicle. What kind of vehicle? Either it is bus, car, bike. These are the vehicles made by man. So we call as vehicles are artificial objects. Cow. Cow is one of the animal made by man or God? Made by God. So we call as cow is example for natural object. Not only cow, all the animals comes under the natural objects. Mountain. Yes, mountain also made by God. So we call as mountain is a natural object. Next is plants. Plants are made by man? No. Plants exist on their own. Plants are also natural. Next is chair. Chair is natural or artificial? Yes. Chair is a artificial because chairs are made by man. Okay, students, you can easily classify the objects are natural or artificial. See, all artificial objects we call as non-living objects. What we call? Non-living objects. All artificial objects are all artificial components we call as non-living objects. Okay. Here, let's see the natural objects. In natural objects, can you see some objects are moving and some are stay at the rest position? Yes. Birds move from one place to another. Cow also move. Mountain, but mountain is in rest position. Plants we are going to learn the topic living world. What is the topic name? Living world. Here the topic name itself indicates that living. Living means in the whole chapter we are going to learn about the living organisms and compare the living organisms with the non-living organisms. Yes, first we see the environment. Environment. How environment is composed of? Environment is composed of both living as well as non-living components. Here, living components. Living component. Or we call as living objects. Second one is opposite of living is non-living. Non-living components. Okay, living components and non-living components. Environment is consist of both living components as well as non-living component. Here we say that natural objects are birds, cow, plants and mountain. By using those examples, now we learn the objects are living or non-living. Okay, before going to learn living component, write down the definition of living components. What is the definition of living components? Yes, write down. Things which can grow, breathe and move, we call as living component or living object. The opposite of living is non-living. Here, what is guess the definition of non-living components? Yes, things which cannot grow, breathe and move, we call as non-living components. Here, if the question asks like write the meaning of living components, you write things which can grow, breathe and move, we call as living component. Here, non-living means things which cannot grow, breathe and move, we call as non-living components. If the question asks like write the difference between living components as well as non-living components, you make the column and write the definition. See, observe here the word can. In living components, we use can. In non-living components, we use cannot. Okay, by using examples, we can check the object are either living or non-living. For example, plants. Okay, tell me students, plants are living components or non-living component? Yes, living component. See, let us check the characteristics of plants is matched with living components or not. See, here first is things. Here the things means we are using plants. Plants which can grow. Is plants are grow? Exactly. When seeds start sprouting and these germinated seeds is slowly starts growing, after that it convert as a plant. So we call as plants grow. Okay. Next is plants breathe? Yes. Plants also living component or living organisms. Plants also breathe like a human beings. Plants respire oxygen gas and breathe out carbon dioxide gas. At the time of photosynthesis or at the time of day, plants use carbon dioxide to make food and breathe out oxygen gas, which is helpful to us. Okay, Here in plants, breathing process takes place. So we call as plants is a living component. Here is plants move. Here human beings are move from one place to another place easily by walking. How plants move? Yes, plants also move because here roots of plants are move underground the earth. Underground are in the earth by searching of water. In the same way, the branches also move in the upward direction. Movement also takes place in plants. For example, in sunflower plants, at the daytime, the sunflower plants are rotating towards the sun. By this example, we can say that plants also move. Our movement takes place in plants also. So we call it as plants is a living component. Okay, example is plants is living component. Next one is wall. Okay, wall is living or non-living? Yes, tell me. Wall is a non-living because wall is made by man. Wall cannot move from one place to another place. If wall is grow, no, wall didn't grow. Okay, because wall is made up of some objects like bricks and sand, etc. So wall cannot grow. Is wall breathe? No, because respiration process didn't take place in wall. So breathing process doesn't take place in wall also. Is wall move from one place to another? No, wall didn't move. So we call as wall is an example for non-living component. Example for non-living component is wall. Okay, next example. Yes, seeds. Is seeds are example for living components or non-living components? Yes, example for living component because in living component example we see that seeds are starts growing, then the seeds germinated, the germinated seeds starts growing and converted as plant. So here seeds also called as living component. If question are asked like either raw seeds and fried seeds, which is living and which is non-living? How can you identify? Yes, raw seeds are living components because if farmers also use raw seeds to sow but didn't use fried seeds to sow, because in raw seeds living component is alive. In fried seeds living components will be destroyed. So fried seeds we call as non-living because in fried seeds living component will be destroyed. Raw seeds, farmers also use raw seeds for sowing. Raw seeds are an example for living components. Next example. Okay, mountain. Is mountain is living or non-living? Mountain is a natural object. Either it is living or non-living? Yes. See, mountain. Is mountain can grow? No, mountain didn't grow. Is mountain breathe? No, mountain did not breathe. Is mountain move from one place to another? No, no one character is matched in case of mountain. So mountain we call as non-living. Example for non-living is mountain. Okay students, I hope you understood the differences between living components and non-living components. Okay, I will give some examples. I will write. You can identify the examples are belongs to living components or non-living. Yes. Yeah. Then. Yes. Vehicle. Then. Table. Insects. Okay. Here is a living or non-living. Here is a natural object. Either it is living or non-living. Here is non-living. Here is non-living. But we respire air. Here is a mixture of many gases. In those gases, oxygen gas we respire. But air move from one place to another place. Air cannot grow. Okay. Air cannot grow, cannot eat. So we call as air is a non-living component. Vehicles. Vehicles can move. Yes, vehicles can move from one place to another place. Vehicles grow? No, because vehicles are artificial, so vehicles cannot grow. Then, vehicles breathe. Vehicles didn't have a respiratory system, but it liberate harmful gases. Okay, so vehicle is non-living. Table is living or non-living? Yes, table is non-living. Insects are living organism because insects move, grow and eat food. And next, by using these living or non-living components, we learn next class the characteristics of living world. Okay, dear students, today in this class, we learn about the meaning of living components, non-living components. And in next class, we learn about the characteristics of living components. Thank you.